Hello everyone, today we'll see the osteology of the clavicle. So clavicle, it is a modified long bone. It mainly supports the shoulder so that the arm can swing clearly away from the trunk, and it also helps in the transmission of the weight, that is from the upper limb to the sternum. Coming to its characteristic features, it is the only long bone which lies horizontally, and it is completely subcutaneous throughout its course. It is having no medullary cavity. It is membranous in its ossification, and it is the only long bone which is having two primary centers, and it is the first bone to ossify. And sometimes the clavicle can be pierced by the middle supraclavicular nerve. Coming to the side determination, how will we determine the side of the clavicle? Like any other long bone, the clavicle is also having two ends, that is the lateral end and the medial end, and one shaft. So the lateral end is flattened from above downwards, whereas the medial end is quadrilateral in shape. And shaft, when we see, it is sinuously curved, where it is divided into medial two-third and the lateral one-third. Here the medial two-third is convex forwards, whereas the lateral one-third is concave forwards. So by these features, and also when we see on the inferior surface of the shaft, there is a groove present which we call it as the subclavian groove, which should be facing downwards. So by seeing these features, we can hold the clavicle in anatomical position. That is, the acromion should come laterally, the medial end, that is quadrangular part, should be facing medially, and the subclavian groove should be facing below. So this is the right side of the clavicle. Coming to the main features, when we see the shaft, here it is sinuously curved, and it is divided into medial two-third and the lateral one-third. When we see the medial two-third of the shaft, it is round in shape. So hence it is having four surfaces, that is anterior surface, posterior surface, superior surface, and the inferior surface. So anterior surface is convex forwards, posterior surface is smooth, superior surface, nearer to the medial end, the rough impression is present, whereas on the inferior surface, when we see laterally, there is a groove present which we call it as subclavian groove, and medially oval shaped impression is present on the inferior surface of the shaft of the clavicle. Coming to the lateral one-third of the shaft, it is flattened from above downwards, and hence it is having anterior border, posterior border, superior surface, and the inferior surface. So anterior border is concave forwards, posterior border is sharp, whereas the superior surface is little bit roughened when we feel. And the inferior surface, there is a tubercle which is present, we call it as conotubercle, and a ridge, that is the trapezoid ridge. Ends, when we see, the acromial end is flattened from above downwards, and the articular surface will give attachment to the acromion process of the scapula, forming acromioclavicular joint, and the margins will give attachment to the joint capsule, whereas the medial end, which is quadrilateral in shape, the articular surface will give attachment to the manubrium sternae, forming the sternoclavicular joint, whereas the inferior part of that articular surface will give attachment to the first costal cartilage, and the margins, articular margin, will give attachment to the fibrous capsule of that particular joint, and superiorly it gives attachment to the interclavicular ligament, whereas anterosuperiorly the articular disc is attached here. Next, coming to the muscle attachments of the shaft, so medial two-third of the anterior surface of shaft of clavicle will give attachment to the pectoralis major, whereas on the superior surface, that is towards the medial end, it gives attachment to the clavicular head of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, whereas posteriorly along the medial end, the sternohyoid muscle is attached. On the inferior surface, laterally, the subclavian groove in the subclavian groove, subclavian muscle is attached, and along the margins it gives attachment to the clavipectoral fascia. Whereas towards the medial end of the inferior surface, the oval shape impression will give attachment to the costoclavicular ligament. Coming to the lateral one third of the shaft, anterior border of the lateral one third of the clavicle will give attachment to the deltoid muscle, whereas the posterior border will give attachment to the trapezius. And this tubercle, that is conoid tubercle and the trapezoid ridge, will give attachment to the coracoclavicular ligament. So these are the attachments of the clavicle. Next, coming to the ossification, the clavicle mainly ossifies from the two primary centers, and except its medial end, whole of the clavicle ossifies in the membranous type of ossification. The primary centers will appear at 4th to 5th week of intrauterine life and fuse at the 45th day, whereas the secondary center for the medial end will arise at 15 to 16 years and it fuses at 21 to 22 years.